escape to the crystal ball for second chances.
I'm asking you to marry me.
There's obviously something that's still between us.
And last chances.
Ryan Lavery, you're under arrest for the rape of Christine Montgomery.
Jillian and I have a plan.
Come on, suckers. Take the bait.
All My Children, Your Great Escape on ABC Daytime.
Previously on All My Children.
Why are you intentionally trying to sabotage my love life? I thought we were finished.
Colby, Liza. Now all I need is a DNA sample of Chandler Adams.
By some wild miracle, a man like Dimitri should ever give you a second look. I should think you wouldn't be foolish enough to toss him aside. You are right. I should have held on to Dimitri.
I got the DNA results from Ryan Lavery's blood sample.
Crystal ball or not, do it.
Sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but don't you think it's time to go home?
Now?
What?
Come on, the evening's young. It's gonna be a wonderful night.
Yeah, we'll just hope it stays that way, but here is not a good place for you.
We're not doing anything wrong.
Listen to your lawyer.
Doing is not the problem. Being here is.
Look, we're not gonna make any trouble, I promise.
The ticking time bomb. Look, you are Edmund's least favorite person in the world right now, and he wants tonight to be perfect. Trouble is gonna come.
But not from us. I'm staying miles away from Edmund and Kit, wherever they are.
Light years might be better.
Look, once the Grand Inquisitor sees the blood test, everybody's gonna finally know that my DNA did not mingle with Kitfish.
No rape, no how. Yeah. Just do your old lawyer a favor, pick up your dancing shoes and start hiking, will ya?
But tonight's my lucky night. Nothing is gonna derail us. Excuse us. Thank you.
What are you gonna do?
Kid, you all right?
I'm fine.
You don't want to still go home, do you?
I can breathe. I can move my arms and legs. I feel much better.
For real?
Thanks for stopping me from bailing.
My pleasure.
You've done a wonderful job tonight, Edmund. This is definitely a night to remember. Your imagination's in overdrive, Tadman.
I don't think so. I think you're doing the same thing to me that Uncle Palmer does to you.
I beg your pardon.
You are intentionally interfering with another person's life, and I think it's just as annoying and just as sneaky.
Well, no one has ever accused me of being sneaky before.
Well, obviously you've never been caught before.
Well, what did I do?
You are intentionally torpedoing my love life in all kinds of devious little ways.
That's pure paranoia.
You know it, and I know it. Come on, admit it. You're scaring him off, aren't you?
Pull high school stunts like some little girl? Why would I do that?
Yeah, why indeed? Because the night at the roadside bar, everything was going along just fine. One minute, my date is as friendly as a kitten. The next minute, she's as cold as ice. And the minute after that, she's gone. Now, nothing had changed with me. I'm still the same guy, but something happened between us, and you were the only other person that was around. What did you do to her?
Maybe it was Liza.
It wasn't Liza. I already asked her.
Well, maybe you believed her?
Why not? Liza'd be bragging about it if she ruined my evening. Fess up. You're the guilty party.
Look, I hope you don't hold me responsible every time your social life doesn't turn out the way you'd like. You know, you're not always irresistible.
Well, I'm damn close. What with my rape your type, wet, boyish good looks, and godlike body. Something is going on, Dixie. 1 minute Paige was here, now she's nowhere to be found. Where'd she go?
I don't know.
You sure? You absolutely sure? I don't think so. I think you're toying with my social life, and it's fairly obvious why.
Oh, really? Why?
Because. No matter how much we deny it, there's obviously something that's still between us. I can feel it, and so can you. Can't you?
Will you save me a dance?
Yes, of course.
Well, I'll be in touch.
I'm looking forward to it.
You look so beautiful tonight. You know, Pine Valley is lucky to have you.
Well, something else, isn't she?
Oh, she's something, all right. Oh, the music is perfect. I'm in the mood to dance. The action's out there. We're in here. What's so important?
You are. And I can't wait another minute to tell you.
Okay. You want to tell me I was important? Okay, done. Okay, go dance.
No, you're more than important. You're the most fabulous, intriguing, incredible woman in the universe.
Maybe on the planet of pregnant people.
Okay. I can't look at anyone else tonight.
Well, it's the power of our planet. But I am a responsible one. I hereby release you from the attraction ray.
No, I cannot go out there and drink champagne and make party chatter until I say to you what I have to say to you.
Party's about having fun. Don't get all serious on me.
But I can't help myself, Liza. I've been serious about this for a long time, and I can't keep it inside me any longer. I love you.
Adam.
I love you. I love you. I've never stopped loving you. Since reason dawned and sanity prevailed, I've loved you, and I will never stop loving you. And I have to ask you to tell me, I beg you to tell me, that perhaps in some small part of your heart, some really small, tiny, quiet place in your soul, there's a part of you that still loves me too.
Really ask easy questions, do you?
Uh-uh. So please, just tell me, Liza, please tell me.
Yes, there is.
All My Children, brought to you by One A Day. We've got the one for you.
No idea how much that means to me. Dare you say it?
No.
I mean, you yourself, actually, I'd hoped. I figured maybe part of you still did love me, but dare you say it. There's nothing in this world I wanted more.
Yeah. Get all gooey on me or anything. I mean, I've loved you.
You've loved
me? Yeah.
I'm not talking about the fond looking back over something quite pleasant kind of love. That's not what I mean.
Who said it was pleasant?
Oh, always armed.
And ready to deploy.
That's my Liza.
You're not gonna run with this, are you? And you trick me into saying something, and then you're going to spring something on me.
Now, when I try to trick you,
is water wet?
Liza, we're inevitable. Separate, we're powerful. But together, We are the fuel that runs the universe.
Ah, and we're modest, too.
And we will always end up together. We are one of the laws of nature.
Well, that's comforting. It is reassuring that we don't have to go searching and questioning. And
right.
We're just destined to spend eternity side by side.
Whatever the fates throw in our path here.
All right. Well, now that we've got that settled, let's go dance.
I see. I know that we can never... Well, we can't be the same two people we were when we met 2 years ago.
Well, thank heavens.
Things will never be the same between us. But maybe they could be better.
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
You're already heading down a gloriously generous and loving path, bringing a new life into the world. I cannot tell you how I admire you for having the guts to take on that responsibility.
Well, I didn't do it so that people would admire me.
I know that, of course not. You did it out of love, but it's still going to be very difficult. A woman alone, raising a child alone, it's going to be very, very demanding.
Well, I'm aware of the obstacles, and I'm not worried about it. I want to do it.
But you don't have to do it alone. That's what I'm trying to tell you. It's wonderful that you want to take on that responsibility. But you don't have to shoulder that burden all by yourself. Why don't we raise this child together? Mother and father. Partners.
Are you?
Yes. I'm asking you to marry me.
I lost track of the time. It's time for the raffle. I'm sorry. Would you excuse me? Attention, please. Thank you. Everybody having a good time? Well, there's nothing like a good party for a worthy cause, and there is one further attraction tonight, and that is the Aruba vacation. Now, Haley and Mateo Santos, if you check your entrance tickets, they will pick the winning number.
All right. Ready? Go.
There it goes. Okay. The winning number for the trip in paradise to Aruba is number 4233.
That's us. We won! 4233, that's us.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Lavery, our lucky winners.
Thank you.
Hey, there you go. Good going, guys. Congratulations.
Thank you. But I really don't think this is right, guys.
What? You saw me pick the ticket fair and square.
No. I mean, you and Mateo should be going to Aruba. We wouldn't have been here if you hadn't invited us. You gave us the tickets.
Yeah. Well, so what? You were the ticket holder, and how would it look if we went to
Aruba? It looks suspicious.
Yeah. Mr. and Mrs. Lavery won. Mr. and Mrs. Lavery should go. You deserve it.
Congratulations. A honeymoon in the islands. Delish.
Wonderful.
Didn't I tell you that tonight was going to be my lucky night?
Don't be packing your bags until this rape thing is settled.
Oh, come on.
I'm just saying what the DA would be saying.
I know, but he's not going to be saying it for much longer.
Yeah, you're going to be innocent.
Yes, that's right. The blood sample is going to prove and everything's right and clear me of all this stuff.
Oh, honeymoon in the islands. I love islands and I love you.
Oh, excuse us.
They better not be counting their coconuts.
We are going to walk in the moonlight.
Swim in the moonlight.
And we're gonna make love until the sun comes up.
Mm.
very gracious of you.
Maria would have wanted it that way.
Well, it must have been difficult. Kit must be very upset. Where is she anyway?
I don't know.
I had nothing to do with your date disappearing.
You are such a bad liar. Look at you. No contact. You turn away. You start to stutter. It's pathetic.
I'm. You say I'm a liar.
That's exactly what I'm saying. Yes.
Your social life has nothing to do with me.
My social life has everything to do with you. I don't make a move lately. Doesn't have something to do with you.
Oh, now you're blaming me for your problems.
Yeah. I would have never moved into Cortland Manor if it wasn't for your little aria about love and family.
You moved into Cortland Manor.
The tie that binds families together, the bond that grows through adversity. Remember that?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. My family is Uncle Palmer.
No, well, don't be ridiculous. Look, wherever that speech came from, it was about a lot more than just Opal and Palmer. Come on, Dixie, I know it. I can tell. There's something going on with you, and it's something that's major.
Well, my family is in turmoil. That's pretty major.
No, that's not it. It's something about you and me. I know it. I can feel it.
You're reading too much into this.
You're trying so hard to avoid telling me. You know I'm going to find out.
Listen, I'm glad that you moved in to Cortland Manor, but it is for Opal's sake, not mine.
Dixie. Honey, life is too short. Let's stop wasting time. Tell me what's going on.
Tell you what's going on? That's not a simple request.
You know, obviously it's not.
Look, when we had those days in New York, they were wonderful days, okay? And what do you want me to say?
I don't know. I'm not the one with the problem. Look, honey, when you didn't show up on top of the Statler, you had obviously decided that you could deal without me, right? That's reasonably simple.
No, it's not simple. It's not simple. It's incredibly complicated, okay?
Dixie, I've been looking all over for you.
Perfect. Right on cue.
Well, you know, they were having this raffle, and, well, we don't have to pack our bags because we're not going to Aruba.
Oh, darn. I lost track of time.
No. That's not our song, but it's close enough. Let's go dance.
No, it's not your song. Excuse us. The lady and I were talking.
And now we're finished talking, okay? I'm sorry your date didn't show up, Ted, but I really do want to dance.
By all means. You said that's the last thing you'd ever do.
I know. It's just that when we get together, there's something wonderful between us, and I just love him so much.
so much that you'd ruin his life to tell him the truth? You know, I thought you were determined to save him the pain of loving and losing you again.
I know that's what I said.
Well, that was very, very honorable of you. To protect the man you love.
It's the right thing to do, right, isn't it?
Well, you made a very, very difficult and loving decision, Dixie. I think you should stick by it. Be strong. Just let him go.
Marry you.
It's not as if we haven't done it before.
No, we haven't done it before. Not really.
Well, okay, right. This time, really, truly. Successfully.
Wait. Slow down. I said that I would give you a second chance. How did that suddenly morph into a wedding?
Well, very naturally.
No. A wedding was not a part of our deal. Are you drunk?
Oh, absolutely. But not on alcohol. Come on, Liza. Nothing ventured, nothing gained.
Marriage.
Yeah? Now, I didn't get to the top of the heap by playing it safe, and neither did you.
Oh, wait. This is my life. This is not some free-for-all stumble up the corporate ladder.
So, the challenge is still exhilarating, isn't it? The pulse quickens. Liza, you and I go for the gold. We're risk takers, both of us. That's why we're such a perfect match.
Well, remarriage to you would definitely be an ultimate risk.
Yes, well, and it also could provide the ultimate, glorious payoff.
But I'm betting for two.
I know. So am I. We could pull this off, Liza. Helping each other. Needing each other. I've never needed you as much as I need you right this minute.
And you think I need you?
I think raising a child is the hardest job in the world. You can do it alone if you want to, if you feel you need to. Do you really want to? You think that's the best choice for your little girl?
She's my responsibility. It's a decision that I need to make.
Yeah, I know. And I don't want to bring you any grief, Liza. I love you more than anything else in this world. But if you decide that you don't want to marry me, I will still love you. I'll do everything in my power to make your life and your little girl's life happy and secure. Liza, when we lost the child that we almost had together. I lost everything. The love that we could have shared, loving that child, the life that we would have created, could never be replaced. But maybe with this child, we could have a second chance. Do all the things we wanted to do before. Create a life that is richer and more rewarding than anything we've ever dreamed of.
Do you think that's possible? Knowing the kind of people that we are?
I think it's quite possible because of the kind of people we are. Do you remember when I gave you your father's medals?
I was very moved.
Yeah, why? You already knew what a hero he was?
Yes, but I thought I was the only one who saw it.
Proving himself in battle was not the issue with you. Because of all the times he'd come to your rescue.
Yeah.
How he bolstered your courage when you needed it most, how throwing together a science project the day before it's due.
Yeah.
Little girls need daddies to be close to. I can make a wonderful daddy for your little girl. And I could be the man
her mommy loves. If you can just give in to the love that you're feeling right now. For her sake. For your sake. Marry me, Liza.
Something that makes you awfully happy.
I think I must have been a saint or something in a past life, Haley. How else could I possibly deserve Julian? I mean, look at her. She's so beautiful. She's so gorgeous. And she loves me. How'd that happen?
Lucky the Irish.
Yeah. I'm crazy about her, Haley.
It happens.
And she would do anything for me. Never in my entire life did I ever think something like this would happen. She trusts me, she adores me. She believes in me completely. Nobody's ever felt that way about
me. I'm very happy for both of you.
Thank you. We definitely did not get here the easy way.
Hey, you got there. That's all that matters. And I have a feeling you're right. It's gonna be your lucky night.
I've never seen devotion like Edmund's to you, Maria. He loves you still with all his heart and soul. Of course, he sees you every day. And Maddie. Children are so beautiful and they're growing up so fast. If only you were here, Maria, his life would be complete. But you can't be. I'm afraid that if Edmund spends the rest of his life looking for someone, another you, someone as smart and perfect, how likely is that? Lightning striking twice? I'm nowhere near good enough. But surely, there's someone out there who can make him happy. He needs to be happy again. That's all I want. It's for Edmund to be happy.
All my children will be back in a moment here on ABC.
Right, and more snow is on the way, the latest at 5.
I didn't mean to intrude. I wanted to get away, and I found myself here. I'm sorry.
Don't be. I come here sometimes myself.
I've seen you.
You know, even though Maria's not actually here, she's always here.
Thank you.
You've had a rough night.
It's not your problem.
You know, I said I'd be at your side, and I meant it.
You've been wonderful to me, Edmund. I appreciate it.
It's cold in here. Let's go back inside, okay?
Okay.
You have no shame, do you? You pull at the heartstrings. You drag out those ghosts of Christmas past. Get whatever you want.
I do whatever I have to do, just like you.
Yes, I know. I have.
I don't hear a no. To grab life by the throat and say yes.
Well, I have wanted to grab you by the throat so many times. It probably will in the future.
Fine. Throttle away if it'll help you make up your mind. Just give me your answer.
I am not going to give you a decision. As much as I want to strangle you, I will not be influenced by romantic music and candlelight. When the time is right, I will give you my answer, and not a minute before, Mr. Chandler.
Magnificent woman.
Dr. Hayward.
Yes, Kyle.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Well, it looks like the children's wing really scored tonight.
And Dr. Santos Gray would be proud.
You know, I assisted her with a research project, too.
Oh.
She was a great doctor.
So I've heard.
Speaking of research, were you able to use those amniotic fluid samples I got you from the lab?
Yes, I did, and they were very helpful, especially one sample in particular. Kyle, it's great to have you on board.
Well, it's an honor working for you.
Have a good night, okay? Oh, excuse me.
Listen,
can I borrow that from you for a minute?
Have fun. Great. Perfect.
Well, thank you for the timely interruption. You're absolutely right. I mean, telling Ty would just be spreading the misery.
Well, courage, Dixie. You gotta stick with the program.
Until I know that I'm 100% well, I won't tell Tad anything.
In the meantime, I'll be your moral support.
Thank you so much.
Let's say we go home.
Erica, do you mind very much if I have this dance with Dimitri?
Oh, now you're pathetic, Brooke. You really are.
Sure.
Be my guest.
Oh, thank you.
Come on.
You moonlighting, Doctor?
I would like to acknowledge a mistake and offer a toast.
Mistake? Surely not one of you.
When you said that you and Liza were getting closer, I had my doubts. But I have never seen Liza as happy as she is this evening.
No.
Yes, well, that's all very interesting. Thank you. But we have some dancing to do, if you'll excuse us.
Generosity of spirit is why we're here this evening.
Ah, yes. Mm. You were saying?
I would like to offer toast to Liza's happiness.
Well, I'll drink to that. Water for me?
Yes, it is.
Thank you.
Yes. Here you go.
To Liza's happiness.
To her health and happiness.
Oh, thank you. You're bleeding. He's bleeding. You might have glass on your head.
Don't worry about it.
Please.
Why don't I take a look at it? Come on.
Oh, well.
Let me see.
This looks terrible.
It looks like a clean cut. You're not any blood thinners, are you?
No, of course not.
Do you think you might need stitches?
I don't think so. I'll go get my bag and I'll dress it for you.
Oh.
Remember what you said about zippers unzipping?
Well, yes, I do. And once we get back to...
Let's go now. Right now, please.
One more dance, my dear.
Whatever you say, my dearest husband. Hey, Derek, how about a bossa nova?
Thanks, no, Opal. Have you seen Edmund around?
Oh, I think he's over that way.
Thanks.
Didn't sever any nerves?
Well, they didn't want to interfere with my dancing.
Shall we?
Oh, I'd love to.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you for the DNA.
Secret.
I know we said the Beau would never find out, but the baby you're carrying is not his.
Could tear a family apart.
He knows something is wrong, Nora.
This baby.
This baby. What? One life to live. Your great escape. ABC Daytime.
I'm here on police business. Oh, the DNA test results are in. I'm in the clear, baby. See, tonight is my lucky night.
It's wonderful.
Well, let's keep this low profile, shall we?
What exactly are you doing?
I'll explain it down at headquarters.
I'm not going to headquarters with you. I'm not going anywhere with you.
You know, this will go a lot easier on you, Lavery, if you cooperate.
I have been cooperating all over the place. I gave you my blood. I've answered all your questions. I happen to be innocent. If you looked at the test results, you'd know that I was innocent. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stay right about here.
Don't spoil the party for everybody, Lavery.
Let's get away from me, all right? I didn't do anything.
Sweetheart, let's just go home. Now, come.
Brian Lavery, you're under arrest for the rape of Christine Montgomery, a.k.a. Kit Fisher.
Oh, no, this is wrong.
You will have the right to remain silent and to refuse
to
answer
questions. Can you do this, Lieutenant?
You understand? Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. Do you understand? You have the right to an attorney and to have an attorney present during questioning. If you can't afford one, an attorney will be appointed for you free of charge.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next All My Children.
Next, all my children.
I think I made a horrible mistake.
Us going back to your place.
What a wonderful idea.
I'm sticking by Ryan, whether you like it or not.
I'm going to sue you for false arrest. I'm going to sue the whole police department. And then I'm going after her.